Backups are security. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. As you probably know, if you've paid any attention to the stuff I've written or published online over the last 18 years, I talk a lot about backups. And a lot of people have a slightly misunderstood perception of just why backups are so incredibly important. When we talk about security, backups are one of the things that people don't think about. And yet, you should. Here's the thing. We talk about backups as being a way to recover from failure, right? So if your hard disk dies, then you can simply replace the hard disk, restore your system from a backup image, and great, you move on as if nothing happened. If you accidentally corrupt a file or delete a file or something like that, it's your backups, be they image backup created by backup software or backups kept online through tools like Dropbox or OneDrive, one way or another, you can get the file back if you have backups. That's the, I'll call it the traditional approach to backing up and why people think backups are important. But there's more. For example, let's say your machine gets malware of some sort. You get a virus or a Trojan and it infects your machine. And you can't remove it. Well, if you simply restore your machine to the state it was in immediately prior to that malware having arrived, you just got rid of it. In fact, restoring a backup image is the only way to guarantee that the malware has been removed. Malware can hide from anti-malware tools, removal tools, processes, and so forth. But if you restore a backup image that was taken prior to the malware even being there, then by definition, it's gone. Your backup is an incredibly important part of security. Not prevention, but in terms of a safety net. It's how you recover. Now, I hear a lot of concern about ransomware specifically. I want to be very clear. Ransomware is just malware. It's just another virus. It's just another Trojan. It's just another whatever. The thing that makes ransomware unique, of course, is that it happens to be particularly destructive, encrypting your data and holding it hostage. But the bottom line is pretty much the same as I was just saying for malware. If you find yourself infected with ransomware, then restoring your machine to the state it was in before the ransomware arrived makes it go away. In fact, a complete image backup of everything on your machine before it was encrypted, when you restore it, means that not only is the ransomware malware itself gone, but the side effects, the encryption of the files on your machine, has also been eliminated because you restored all those files from your most recent backup. Now, the objection that I get whenever I talk about this is that ransomware encrypts backups. A couple of things on that. One, that's not a reason to not back up. You should be backing up regardless. Not all malware is ransomware. So you're still going to be protected from all that other malware. Not all ransomware encrypts backups. So you'll still be protected from all that other ransomware. Many backup tools now take specific steps to protect the backups they create from ransomware specifically. Macrium Reflect, the one I use on my machine on a daily basis, has such a feature. It's called Image Guard, I believe. And it means that if your machine gets ransomware, well, the backups aren't going to be encrypted. Backups, of course, kept offline are out of the reach of ransomware. But the bottom line is that the fact that ransomware might, just might, encrypt your backups doesn't mean you shouldn't back up. You should be backing up regardless. So, I hear you saying, if ransomware can't encrypt data that's not present, I'll just disconnect my backup drive when I'm not backing up. Don't do that. Seriously, don't do that. I know you've got the best of intentions. You will attach your hard drive and back up manually on a regular schedule? No, you won't. You just won't. You will forget. You'll have great intentions and you'll do it for a while, and then eventually, you'll forget. You'll get out of the habit. The fact is, you will not have a backup when you need it because, I've been forgetting to attach my backup drive and it's been a month since I've gotten a good backup. You don't want to be in that situation. Remember, ransomware that affects your backups is a small subset of everything that your backups protect you from. Automated backups, making sure that they can run without your intervention, is significantly more important than any fear you might have about your backups being encrypted by ransomware. If you are still concerned about that, flip it around. Let the automated process happen every day. That way you know you're protected from all that other stuff that isn't out there encrypting your backups. Now, the manual part, the part that you need to remember every once in a while. Make a copy of the backup. Make a copy of the backup and take it offline. Take it out of the reach of ransomware. You'll feel better in these very small cases where you might have actually gotten ransomware that encrypted your backups. You've got an offline copy. But because you've been backing up daily or regularly or whatever your schedule is, automated without having to remember, you'll have your backups for everything else that can possibly go wrong. That's more important. It's okay. I'll say it's less impactful if you forget to update your offline backup copy, because you'll still be protected from all this other stuff. But if you do, once a week, once a month, something like that, take a copy of your backup offline, great. Just make sure you're not interfering with the automated backup process that happens whether or not you think about it. It's that simple. Backing up is that important. So, now that you've protected yourself from hardware failure and mistakes like deleting files, you're now in a position where your backup is part of your overall security strategy, acting as a safety net for when, not if, something goes wrong. I hope that helps. I hope that helps clarify why backups are so incredibly important. For updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/147489. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.